Oh, be careful there.
Thank you.
didn't let y'all stay down there?
You said what?
They didn't let y'all stay down there?
Oh, they didn't say anything. I wasn't sure if we were allowed.
Huh?
They didn't say anything. I wasn't sure.
Oh, the sun's gonna go down in a half hour, so. Yeah, get covered by all the folks and the trees and all that.
Mm-hmm. This is good.
I don't know how this always gonna sound.
I just got an interview with some of his friends down there. We saw
y'all.
Oh, yeah, I didn't realize you were back. Yeah,
because I was right here talking to the mirror.
Uh-huh.
And he was asking if I was on the stuff. I was like, no, I have a little photo of a funny thing. He's down there for a while. Russ?
You saw Anne? Did you see Anne?
Yeah, she's over here. She's down there somewhere. But still.
Did she find herself?
She takes great stills.
She can probably. For digital?
Huh?
She's taking stills for digital?
Uh huh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I didn't recognize her without her mask at first. I was like, who's that? I never seen her without her mask.
Yeah. Dang, that's crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy
I know.
You gotta say that.
Like, if I saw her on the street without her mask, I wouldn't know who she was.
Yeah. All right, look, down this way, you see him? Is this that the darn? I gotta get a picture of this. I just hate the darn sun. Is it going to turn this way? I don't know what the man looked like. I don't know what the man looked like. He posted a meeting. He posted a meeting. And where's coach? Where's coach? Oh, you're talking about bump shot? Bump shot? Bump shot? Okay. Alright, I'll be quiet. It's about to start. Alright?
Good evening. Good evening, parents, community members, students, teachers, and players. And welcome to Jack Alkhatib High School. My name is Gerald Garrett, and I'm principal here. And right now, my heart is overflowing with pride and excitement of how many people come out this evening to celebrate the life of Jack Alkhatib. On a typical Friday night, at this time of the fall, we would have just heard the national anthem and began a football game. You and the fans would be yelling, our band would be playing, yelling, feeling the cheeks, and the behind me would be playing. Tonight is not a typical Friday night for high school. It's not typical enough players, our fans, or our community. It's not typical because this past Tuesday, Judge Falk lost. And Judge Falk is rare news. But on this past, despite the best efforts of our trainers and EMS, and despite the prayers and cheers of our coaches and family and friends, we lost. We all lost. This past Tuesday evening, we lost Jack. Jack's parents lost a son. Brother lost a brother. Jack's classmates lost a friend. Our teachers lost a student. And our players lost a teammate. Tonight is not a typical Friday in our community, and it hurts. So I ask that you keep his family and our school and our community in your prayers in the days and weeks and months to come. Tonight, we want to focus on what we didn't lose, because Jack was not just a great football player. He was a great person. We will never forget Jack's character, his work ethic, his personality, his tenacity, and his commitment to help others. We won't forget the evening he left practice to help a family that had lost everything in a fire. We won't forget the time he gave his teammates a ride home for practice when they needed one. We won't forget the times after school he helped his classmates in study. While Jack may no longer be with us here at Dutch Falls, his legacy will live on forever in our hallway. At this time, Coach Hinton will come forward and lead us in a prayer.
All hearts and minds clear. Let us bow in a word of prayer. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we come before you trying to understand, trying to mend our sin. But Father, we ask that you remind us that you are God of God, Kings of Kings, and Lord of Lords. And you said to us that earth has no soul that heaven cannot be. Father, remind us that you said that every man must come to meet his maker. Father, you said that we know not the day nor the hour, and you come like a thief in the night. Father God, you came by on Tuesday, and you took our brother Jack. And Father God, our hearts are heavy. But we know to look to you, to look to the hills, for whence cometh our help. Father, you are a way maker when there's no way. You are a healer of all wounds. We ask that you touch each student, each coach, each family member. Stop by the Alkhatib High. touching that green room with all of them. Father, we can only say to you that you are God. And with you, there is healing. We ask that you take 60 seconds and just reflect on Jack. Let everyone say amen. 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 We will now have a solo by Miss Michelle Cosgrove.
But now
some great singing. Thank you very much. I have the honor to give you guys some memories of Jack, and I feel privileged. I was the first one to meet him. He was a fifth grader. They were leaving from Peakwood to make the transition to Dutch Fork, and had the opportunity to work with him and his brother in the weight room, training techniques and stuff. The fun thing about Jack, I looked in his eyes as a 10-year-old, and I could really see the desire that he wanted to be the best that he could be. Often I would put him on the light bar so, you know, he can come up and teach it step by step. And every time I look over, he's grabbing the big bar. He wants to do what his brother was doing. So we're very privileged to meet him at such an early age. I talked to some of our guys. Most of them would say he's my best friend. I talked to probably about 10, 12 guys, and they all say, Jack is my best friend. And so that means a lot. That means a lot. Also, one of our coaches, I was just talking to him, he said the last thing Jack told him was, Coach, I love you. And Lata, you don't have to say it. You can just see the love that he has for people in his eyes. He's just, that's the kind of guy he is, guy he was. And what we have to do as Dutch Fork people and the community, never, ever forget Jack. He was one of a kind. And I'll tell anybody that. He was probably the most lovable kid that I've ever seen. But you get him on the football field, all that change, okay? I'm just telling you facts. So he know how to turn it on and turn it off. And but for the most part, he was always a loving guy. He would knock the guy down the field, make him look real bad, get him up, all right, okay? Knock him down again. But that's just Jack. He gave 110%, okay? Whether that was looking out for his fellow students, teammates, he did that. It was nothing. That's just what he did. And so I'm so blessed and honored to have the opportunity to know him. Thank you. We have our defensive coordinator. He's going to come up, Scott Braswell, and going to introduce the next speaker.
Thank you, guys. And now, representing Coach Knox is his wife, Keisha. Jack, breathe. Players and coaches.
watched in disbelief and in the horror. We prayed. We screamed. We held each other's hands. We cried in pain and anguish. Jack, get up. I can't imagine the pain that mom and dad and big brother feel. I know the pain these players and coaches feel is deep, dark, ugly, and real. We have asked God 100 times, why? Everyone says that time heals everything. That's been my strategy in dealing with previous tragedies. That's not going to work this time. Somehow, we must do more than wait on Father Time to heal us. And then I got an email from Pastor Blair Smith, First Baptist Church. He offered his condolences and special wisdom. He referred our football family to 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 2 through 4. God of all comfort, God who comforts us in our pain, so that we may comfort each other. So here we are, comforting each other. And here we are, celebrating Jack's life. Let us not mourn. Let us comfort and love each other. Let us celebrate Jack's life. I want to lead this celebration with his family and teammates. I want to cry out, he is special. I've never heard a contrary word about Jack. Big number 60 had us laughing, smiling, and loving. He had us in the palm of his hand with his big old teddy bear personality. So let's stand up. Lift our hands and eyes to heaven. Let's celebrate Jack's life. As Dr. Ross told our team, let's live for Jack. Let's honor his memory by embracing what he stood for. Let's live in his image, displaying the great traits that made him the great son, brother, teammate, friend that he was to all. Rest in peace, big number 60. Guard the good Lord's blind side. And until we see you again, we trust our God that you are home now. We love you, Jack. Ready to release the balloon.
Release balloons so that we can send our warm wishes, our memories, and our love up to Jack. So as these balloons climb into the sky, we can all take comfort in the fact that Jack feels the love of everyone gathered here this evening. Jack has touched each and every one of our lives. And with that said, we send our love up to Jack. Concludes our celebration for Big Jack number 6.
I know.
All right. All right. You got enough sound in your room?
I think I got plenty of sound. Our interview was really long.
Okay.
And then we also have your interview back earlier, so I think we've got enough sound.
I'm about to leave.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks, Jack. All righty.
Well, that was a good sign, man.
Very
good. Yeah.